By the time you are listening to this, for the UK and the US may very well have declared climate emergencies. As heat wave and wild fires are wreaking deadly havoc on life and property across both continents. Analysts estimate the economic damage to Europe alone will be at least half a point of gross domestic products or GDP. As a fighting from energy and food production to tourists, and everyday life has been greatly disrupted, Great Britain record is hottest day ever on July 19th. White temperatures hitting a record high of 14.3 degrees Celsius, Celsius degrees Fahrenheit in the east of England. According to the country Met Office, London Fire Brigade declared a major incident after a house surge in force across the capital on Tuesday. Record high temperatures across China have turned deadly, with reports of dozens of fatalities due to heat strokes, and Chinese officials have begun restricting power to factories to ensure sufficient supply for air conditioners. 76 weather stations in China report record high temperatures last week that ascended 42 degrees Celsius Fahrenheit in some places. Here in the U.S., a heat wave moving its way across the country has already produced satellites, citing highest temperatures this past Sunday and could bring readings as high as 8 degrees in Texas and Oklahoma this week. About 14 million people are under heat alerts in the lower 48 states, according to the National Weather Service or NWI. So, what can political leaders do beyond declaring climate emergencies, and what does it mean if they do make those declarations? It's a complicated question, as you can imagine, particularly now, given the rampant inflation in the energy market. While oil prices have come down in recent weeks as global economies brace for a recession, energy demand will remain strong as air conditioner installations around the world will be on full blast. In the U.S., the Biden administration issued an emergency declaration called reducing federal funding to clean energy consumption. It called also steer aid to communities on the front lines of climate change and even curbs the export of fossil fuels behind global warming. The president, by executive order, count up more than 100 special powers normally intended to address hurricanes, terrorist attacks, and other unforeseen events. For example, under the Stafford Disaster Relief and Emergency Assistance Act, the president could direct the Federal Emergency Management Agency to construct renewable energy products using federal money. He could also enact a national security exemption in a law that lifted a decades-long ban on Moscow exports, reimposing licensing requirements and other restrictions to shuttle overseas oil sales. The problem, of course, is that high oil and gas prices are putting pressure on the administration to permit more production. Not to mention the fact that President Biden has been trying to push his Build Back Better plan through Congress, which calls for more spending and investment in renewable energy, and it has faced strong opposition from Senator Jay Manchin of West Virginia. Among others and many of the executive powers, High Minister tried to push through, but also faced challenges in the Supreme Court.